since IPO, I think we're at around about a sort of 37-38% total return on our NAV. And over the last 12 months or so, we've done about 4% in a quite a difficult market.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. I'm joined by Tom Williams. He's manager of Darning Renewables and Infrastructure Trust. Tom, very good to speak with you today. And before we get into your interim results, which were out last week, could you remind us about the fund and what you're invested in?
Yeah, of course. Well, look, first of all, thank you very much for having me on the show again. Really pleased to be here and really pleased to be able to talk to our investors. So DORE, Downing Renewables and Infrastructure Trust, is an investment trust focused on renewable energy and other infrastructure in the UK and Northern Europe. We are a well-diversified trust. In fact, we have a central theme of our strategy being diversification. We are invested in about 37 now hydropower plants in Sweden and Iceland. We have a wind farm investment in Sweden. We have investments in solar in the UK, and we also have some investments in grid services business, a very exciting sector that we think has got real prospects. We try and deliver a stable and consistent yield and also produce some capital appreciation through the strategy. Actually, it's going pretty well, actually, over the past 3.5 years since we IPO'd.
Well, talk to us about your recent performance then, Tom, and how you've been doing.
Yeah, and I guess that's what we're particularly pleased about. So since IPO, I think we're at around about a sort of 37-38% total return on our NAV. And over the last 12 months or so, we've done about 4% in a quite a difficult market. Interestingly enough, that makes us the second best performing fund on an average return basis in our peer group of all 16 listed infrastructure investment trusts.
Take us through the initiatives that have gotten you to that, Tom. So in particular, your asset optimization initiatives over the last 6 months.
At Downing, we have invested heavily over the last about 4 or 5 years in building up our asset management functions in-house. So what that means is that we have teams of people, about 35 of them at the moment, actually, who focus solely on preserving and enhancing value in the investments that our funds make. So in particular, for DORE, there have been a number of different initiatives. The first of which is actually in the Gabriel wind farm in Sweden, where we have undertaken a range of initiatives from contract renegotiation, so improving the costs and the service to be provided by our O&M contractors, through to extending land agreements. The totality of those investments have seen a very significant uplift. It's actually a particular asset, as an example, is now held at a value that is 50% higher than the value that we acquired that 2 years ago. And we've also distributed a very significant amount of distributions in that period from that asset as well. So they are focused on a whole range of initiatives to deliver that. The wind farm is one example. The other example, which is really one that is driving a lot of value currently in the portfolio and a lot of value to come in the portfolio, is the initiative around our hydro portfolio, where we are aggregating small hydro assets, we're gaining economies of scale, and then we are modernizing and digitalizing those assets to be able to operate them differently in a way that enhances revenues in today's very different markets from perhaps how they've been operated in the past. And the combination of all of those initiatives is really that we're able to drive increased revenues in the operational assets, which we're improving operational performance. And so we're seeing NAV growth even at times when perhaps the energy markets around us are declining. So we're making up for that loss of future value and loss of future income on the future curves and the energy prices by bringing forward operational improvements in the underlying assets.
Tom, you have announced that you're in talks to sell your interest in that and Gabriel's wind farm in Sweden. And obviously, as you mentioned, as a big uplift to your initial investment. Talk us through your asset disposal strategy and how you recycle that capital.
That decision is really born out of what I was just talking about. So we've put through a lot of the improvement initiatives that we identified when we acquired that asset 2 years ago. We feel like now is a really good time to be able to realize the value that we've created and then reinvest that capital into the ongoing modernization program and aggregation strategy in the hydro, where we feel we can get greater returns than if we just held the wind farm at the current valuation that we have.
And following the end of the reporting period, you agreed to buy 3 hydropower plants in Sweden. So adding to that hydropower investment.
Yeah, exactly. So we just think that that hydropower portfolio is a really powerful driver of value in the fund. And we think that there's a lot of long way to go with the existing assets. And we think that if we are adding to that portfolio, then we can start to capture even more value by bringing assets in at the start of that modernization journey and then realizing value as we bring them through the modernization and digitalization program over the months and years to come.
Tom, over the period, you also continued your share buyback program. You bought back 4.2 million shares over the 6 months. Is that something you're going to continue with?
Yeah, absolutely. So one of the things that we've been talking to our investors about over the last 18 months is really about the very careful decisions that we make around capital allocation. So buying back shares when we're at the discount that we're at, it is incredibly valuable to our shareholders. Now, everything else we do is measured against the benchmark of, okay, there's a great return to be had simply by buying back our shares, which we believe are too cheap. But also, looking at that, what else can we do that gives us similar returns over the medium and long term? And so with the share price where it's been, we've been very active. In fact, I think we've been one of the most active people in the sector on a percentage basis. Actually, our buyback program is actually one of the largest when you look at it as a percentage of the fund. And that has driven lots of value. But equally, we balance that with other decisions where we really think we can deploy capital to get the biggest kind of bang for our buck. And there are places like the hydropower portfolio, amongst other places, where we think we can get returns that are similar or better than the buyback program. And so we're constantly making those decisions about where to allocate that scarce capital.
Tom, talk to us about the second half of your financial year and beyond. What are your future prospects looking like?
Well, I think with the recent announcement that we've made about entering into exclusivity to sell the Swedish wind farm, we've provided a route map really for what our plans are. So they are to proceed with that sale, conclude it, bring back the capital into the fund to pay down the revolving credit facility that we have at the fund level, which then means that we have no borrowing at the fund level, borrowing in the underlying assets, but will have repaid all of the revolving credit facility. We will then have a balance left over. That balance will then be, we'll look at that balance and decide about future growth prospects. And there are a number of really interesting initiatives and value accretive initiatives that we're looking at in the hydropower portfolio, buying new assets, as we've just announced, or investing further into various different modernization and digitalization aspects of the portfolio to access kind of new markets like the frequency markets in Sweden, for example. And we'll also balance that, as I've just been talking about, with having a bit more capital to fund that ongoing share buyback program.
Tom, I hope you'll keep us updated on any further progress. Thank you very much for the update today.
Well, and thanks again for having me on. Delighted to be able to speak to everybody once again. Thank you.
Very welcome. That's Tom Williams. He's Darling Renewables and Infrastructure Trust Manager.